but you see, what troubles me is the amount of influence you had. We've seen communications from senior figures in Washington who feared that you, a lobbyist, could destroy their careers with a snap of your fingers. Is this reputation something you've cultivated, Miss Sloane?
Upon the advice of counsel, I must respectfully decline to answer your question based on my rights under the Fifth Amendment to the United States Constitution.
You see, it's bad enough one person having that much influence, but if they're out of control, if she has a problem, an addiction, well, it would be like the ship of American politics is being steered by a drunk. Do you, or have you ever had any problems with substance abuse?
Upon the advice of counsel, I must respectfully decline to answer your question based on my rights under the Fifth Amendment to the United States Constitution.
I understand you have difficulty sleeping. We subpoenaed medical records. You're a long-time sufferer from chronic insomnia. You regularly work over 16 hours a day, but you can't get off to sleep. Is this accurate?
Upon the advice of counsel, I must respectfully decline to answer your question based on my rights under the Fifth Amendment of the United States to the Constitution, whatever.
You were prescribed multiple courses of benzodiazepines, but according to the deposition of one of our witnesses, you've been procuring off prescription a course of psychostimulants with the aim of keeping you awake a little longer. Is this true, Ms. Sloane?
Upon the advice of counsel, I must respectfully decline to answer your question based on my rights under the Fifth Amendment to the United States Constitution.
Okay, getting back to this business of the Asian Republic of Indonesia.
I'm not a drug addict, and this line of questioning has no relevance in this case. My medication doesn't affect my judgment any more than a double espresso. And speaking of intoxication, I can recite from memory a list of upstanding elected senators who voted on legislation while severely inebriated. And just so you know, I think by now we are fully aware and in no danger of forgetting that Indonesia is a republic which happens to be situated on the continent of Asia.
Miss Sloane, welcome to the party.
Five years. Was it really worth it? 5 years minimum.
What's 5 years?
Offer some puerile quip about Indonesia being in Asia. I mean, can't you see that whole construct was designed to... And it worked.
Are you going to tell me what 5 years is?
You fell for it.
The smartest operative on the Hill just got played by Grandpa Simpson.
Is it how long this conversation's going to be?
It's the going rate for perjury for Congress. Now you've thrown out the Fifth. Anyone who wants you in the ground, that's a lot of people, they are hard at work, dedicating their creative and intellectual efforts to catching you in a lie.
Well, what if I just stay silent?
Well, that's a great idea.
Shit, why didn't your lawyer think of that?
If I refuse to answer...
They will throw you in jail for contempt of Congress! You just blown this thing wide open!
Calm down, Daniel. You're starting to look like you care.
No. I don't care about you any further than I can throw you. I work for the one ethical lobbying practice on the Hill, and I wind up defending the poster child for the most morally bankrupt profession since faith healing. Your car's downstairs. Go home. Stare at the ceiling. Get ready to be crucified.
I know I don't have the most stellar record in heeding your advice.
Don't perjure yourself.
Too bad things didn't pan out with Elizabeth.
Oh, we have other options. What the hell is Amish chicken?
A marketing exercise?
No, we'll just try and find ourselves another lobbyist.
I was talking about the Amish chicken.
She's your enemy now. I invited you here because nobody is better placed to neutralize her than us.
We worked together for years.